Hello students, good morning one and all. In last session already we discussed about vector algebra. In this session I have to start calculus part. Here in this calculus part already you studied little bit concept in first PUC or first inter. In second inter or second PUC, we have to study briefly calculus part. Actually, here calculus means in first inter or first PU, you study limits and derivatives. Limits and derivatives chapter. So here, what is meant by limit? What is meant by derivative? Limit means, for example, limit extends to 1, f of x is equal to something f of 1. So this is called limit. I mean, we have to define the range of this value, that is called limit. Derivative means, that is the rate of change of y with respect to x is called derivative. Here, before going to derivatives, we must know what is meant by calculus, what are the parts of a calculus, how we can study calculus, what are the application of a calculus, okay? So what is the technical applications of calculus, what is the technical definition for calculus, okay? Here, calculus means calculation of various graphs. Calculation of various graphs is called calculus. Dear children, you know the area of a triangle formula. You know the area of a circle formula. So, you know the area of a rectangle formula. Tell me, what is the area of a parabola? So, this is parabola, no? So, what is the area of a parabola? No, we can't tell. Okay, to find out this area, we can use the calculus. Tell me, what is the area of the ellipse? This is the ellipse. Okay, so what is the area of this ellipse? What is the volume of the ellipse? Okay, to find out this area, to find out this ellipse, to find out volume of this ellipse, we can use calculus. Here, calculus means calculation of various graphs is called calculus. And again, calculus means not only to find the area and to find the volume of the graphs, and also to find the slope of the tangents. Slope of the tangents. To find the slope of the tangents is also one of the application of calculus. Actually, calculus can divide into two parts. One is differential calculus. Differential calculus. Another one is integral calculus. This differential calculus, it will come under part 1 NCERT textbook. This integral calculus, it will come under part 2 textbook. Now we come to know what is differential calculus, what is meant by integral calculus. So differential calculus means it is a part of a calculus. It is a part of a calculus, okay, to find the slope of the tangent of the curve. To find the slope of the tangent of the curve is called differential calculus. What is mean by integral calculus means it is also part of the calculus to find the area and volume of the curve. Okay, so that is called integral calculus. Okay, these two are technical definition for differentiation and integration. Okay, now this integral calculus we must know laterly in another classes, later classes. Okay, we have to study this integral calculus. This integral calculus you have to study laterly. Okay, now we come to know what is meant by differential calculus, what is meant by differentiation. Okay, what is meant by differentiation? Here differentiation means differentiation having two definitions. One is basic definition, another one is technical definition. So what is basic definition means here, for example, I have to take dy by dx. Here y is the independent variable. This is independent variable. Independent variable. Here x is called dependent variable. Dependent variable. This dy by dx is nothing but derivative. It is not a differentiation. It is a derivative. Okay. Actually, differentiation means, so to finding the slope of the tangent of the curve is called a differentiation. For example, I'll show in the graph. Okay. Observe here. That is, this is the curve. Okay. So, and again, see, now this is the curve, this is x naught, this is x1, this is y naught, this is y1. Now the curve is bending here. Here how much is bending? That is called slope. Okay, so how much is bending? That is called slope. Slope of the tangent. Finding the slope of the tangent of the curve is called differentiation. Okay, differentiation means to finding the slope of the tangent of the curve is called what? Differentiation. This is technical definition for differentiation. Okay, technical definition for differentiation is to finding the slope of the tangent of the curve is called differentiation. Technical definition for integration means to finding the area and volume of the curve is called integration. Here actually differentiation meaning, see, don't confuse. Definition is different, meaning is different, technical definition is different, general definition is different. Okay, so differentiation meaning means differ means separate the variables. Meaning of differentiation is differ means separate. Okay, so difference. Okay, separate the variables. Okay, so that is differentiation meaning. Integration. So here differentiation and integration, these two are main parts of calculus. Okay, main parts of calculus. These differentiation and integration are twins of the calculus. Without differentiation, integration is not there. Without integration, differentiation is there. But these two are twins of calculus. Okay, differentiation meaning means separation. Separation. Integration meaning means summation. Okay, but definitions are different. Okay, so differentiation definition means to finding the slope of the tangent of the curve is called differentiation. That is technical definition for differentiation. Integration means, that is to finding the volume and area of the curve. Is called integration. Okay, so integration meaning means summation, differentiation meaning separation. Okay, so now observe the students, this is the curve, and again here how much is bending, that is called slope. To finding the slope of the curve is called differentiation. Clear? Okay, so I studied differentiation definition, and I studied differentiation meaning, and I studied by using geometrically representation of differentiation. Okay, now what is meant by derivative? Derivative means the rate of change of y with respect to x is called derivative, not a differentiation. Derivative is different, don't confuse children. Differentiation is different.
डेरिवेटिव इज डिफरेंट, डिफरेंशियबिलिटी इज डिफरेंट. ओके, थ्री वर्ड्स आर डिफरेंट, सो नॉट ए थ्री वर्ड्स आर इक्वल. डेरिवेटिव मीन्स द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ y विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू x इज कॉल्ड डेरिवेटिव. ओके, हियर y इज कॉल्ड इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, x इज कॉल्ड डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. दिस d by dx is nothing but the rate of change of. So this d by dx, okay, this d by dx is there, no? This d by dx means the rate of change of this. Suppose y is there means the rate of change of y with respect to x. Okay, that means y is here independent variable. This y variable is depends upon x variable. Okay, so this y variable is depends on x variable. This is called derivative. Now I will tell what is the difference between differentiation and differentiability and derivative. Observe, actually here dy by dx, dy by dx, the rate of change of y with respect to x, this is called derivative. Differentiation means the process of finding the derivatives. For example, d by dx of dy by dx is nothing but what? D square y by dx square. And again, d by dx of d square y by dx square equals to d cube y by dx cube. The process of finding the derivatives is called differentiation. Derivative means the rate of change of y with respect to x is called derivative. The process of finding the different derivatives, that is called differentiation. Clear? Okay. Now come to what is meant by differentiability. That differentiability, I will give the brief explanation for differentiability in later classes. But I will tell what is the meaning of differentiability. So already learnt LHL and RHL. LHL means what? Left hand limit. RHL means what? Right hand limit. But here LHD and RHD. LHD means left hand derivative. RHD means right hand derivative. Left hand derivative is equal to right hand derivative, that is called differentiability. Okay, this is derivative, this is differentiation, this is differentiability. Here derivative means the rate of change of y with respect to x, that is called derivative. The rate of change of y with respect to x, that is also called derivative. Suppose the rate of change of displacement with respect to time, this is also derivative. This is called velocity. This velocity is a derivative. The velocity is a derivative. Okay, in first PUC, in physics chapter, you studied motion of a particle. Motion of a particle or motion in one plane. Okay, so there you studied general equations of motion. S is equal to ut plus half at square, v is equal to u plus at, those equations. You studied already basic definition for velocity, acceleration, displacement and some torque and momentum, some another physical quantities. Okay, here velocity means the rate of change of displacement with respect to time. This displacement is depending upon time. I'll give one best example, children. So now I am in Bangalore. Now I will go for Bangalore to Hyderabad. Now I'll fix the time. Now I am starting now. Starting point is Bangalore. I'll fix the time. Within 10 hours I have to reach the Hyderabad. Clear? But while going so much traffic is there. That's why it will take nearly 12 to 13 hours. See, displacement means our velocity is dependent upon what? Time. Displacement or velocity or speed is depending upon what? Time. Already if it's the time, Bangalore to Hyderabad, it is 10 hours, but it will take 12 to 3 hours. But automatically velocity also decreases, speed also decreases because of time. It will take 12 to 13 hours. That's why velocity also decreases, that speed also decreases, that acceleration also decreases, because it's depend upon the time. That's why this is called dependent variable, this is called independent variable. This velocity is depends on what? Time. Clear? This velocity, it depends on what? This time. That's why this is independent variable, this is dependent variable. Actually, here this is called velocity. Now we come to know acceleration. What is acceleration? The rate of change of velocity with respect to time is called acceleration. This is also derivative. The rate of change of y with respect to x is called derivative. The rate of change of velocity with respect to time is called acceleration. And some other physical quantities also derivatives. Okay, derivatives means the rate of change of y with respect to x is called what? Derivative. The process of finding the derivatives is called differentiation. I got d square by dx square, d cube by dx cube, d to the power of 4 by divided by dx to the power of 4, similarly so on. And what is differentiability? Differentiability means LHD equals to RHD, that is called differentiability. I think all of you got difference between derivative, differentiation and differentiability. Clear? I think all of you clear. Now, what are the applications of differentiation? It has vast applications of differentiation. It has vast applications. Okay, in world we can use so much applications of differentiation. I'll tell some applications. All of you seen the current. Current is flowing to using electrons and neutrons. Suppose I'll switch on the switch. The current is passed in the wire. When the current is passed in the wire, it will give the emission of light. That emission of light, how much its velocity? In 10 seconds, how much emission? In 1 minute, how much emission? In 20 minutes, how much emission of light? In 10 minutes, how much passing of electrons? How many electrons is passing in the wire? Mainly, we can use the differentiation electronics and electric circuits. Mainly differentiation is used for electric circuits. In higher classes, it will come to Laplace transforms. That Laplace transform, it is a part of a differentiation. That Laplace, without Laplace transforms, there is no electric circuits, there is no electronic circuits, there is no softwares. Without differentiation, without Laplace transforms, there is no softwares. there is no civil engineering. I mean, mainly you can use engineering and technology. Engineering and technology. Engineering and technology. And it is one of the main application of the differentiation is, I mean, pharmacy. In pharmacy field, how's our pharmacy field? I mean, to production of one tablet, it will take differentiation concept, it will take Laplace transform concept, okay? And farming means, agriculture department, okay? Agriculture department. So these are the main application of calculus, okay? So what is meant by differentiation? What is meant by derivative? What is meant by differentiability? What are the applications of differentiation, okay? So these are the main concepts of differentiation. Technical definition for differentiation is to find in the slope of the tangent. Basic definition is finding the rate of change of y with respect to x. That is called basic definition, technical definition. Clear? Integration means summation, and also to find in the area and volume of the curve, that is called integration. Okay? So this is the introduction of differentiation. Okay? In next class, we have to discuss, without continuity, we can't study differentiation, we can't study differentiability. In next class, I'll discuss about continuity concept, okay? Thank you, one and all.